Hello everyone, welcome to this talk on technical writing with Shad Mirza. My name is Ishita Deswal, core team member at Developer Student Club Kite. We are a community of developers who love to learn, share and code together. Basically, we have planned this to be a live session, but due to some issues, we are premiering it now. So let's begin with a definitive guide to blogging as a developer.
Hello everyone, my name is Shad and today we are going to talk about blogging as a developer. We will talk about some questions like, should I start blogging, or what are the benefits of blogging, why you should blog, how to start a blog and how to structure your blog, and what are the some blogging best practices, etc. But first of all, thank you so much for having me. I feel really fortunate enough to be speaking in front of you all. So before we start, a little bit about myself. I am a developer at Hashnode. Hashnode is a blogging platform that lets you write your blogs on your own domain without any hassle. And I like writing technical articles. You can find my blog posts on iamshadmirza.com. In my free time, I like sketching and I am a huge fan of tea. And if you want to connect with me, you can find me as iamshadmirza everywhere on the internet. So let's start with this first question. Should I start blogging or should I start writing a blog? So whenever we are starting something new, we often underestimate ourselves and think that we are not good enough. I think what is happening here is we are suffering from some kind of imposter syndrome. So and in our mind, what we are thinking is that, do I have enough expertise or will people want to read me, but I'm just a beginner, or do I have something new to offer, and what if I make mistakes? So these are really genuine concerns, and even I had these concerns when I started writing, so you are not alone. So we will go through each one and talk about them so that you get a better idea on how to tackle them. The first one is, do I have enough expertise? Or I can rephrase it like that. If you might think that I am not expert enough to write on this topic. So let me tell you one thing, that no one else is. We all are in our own position and we all are learning at our own pace. And we think that there is ton of stuff to learn. So if you are waiting to become an expert and then start sharing, and so that might not never happen. What I will suggest is to don't forget about being an expert and share what you have acquired so far in terms of knowledge. And I think that the best time to write for a person is right when he is a beginner. Actually, what happens is when you are beginner, you are trying a lot of things and you are discovering new problems in your own way and you are solving them and document your own solutions for the problems you got is an excellent way to write about it. And these problems might be unique to you and an expert might not know that they exist. So in this context, being a beginner is a massive plus point, and you can definitely try out new things and try to solve your problems and then document your findings. And this also answered the second question, will people want to read me? If you are trying something and you got a problem, then there is a good chance that someone else might stumble on that problem as well. So if that person Googles the issue and then he will find your article, and who knows, it might help him or help them. So this is a good reason to write. And the fourth point is, do I have something new to offer? So for this question, I will say that we are actually not discovering anything new. We are just finding patterns in the already available topics. We are just approaching the same problem with our own perspective and finding our unique ways to solve them. And that unique way will make your blog unique, not something new to offer part. So this often happens that I I read one article and it doesn't help me to see the whole picture, and if I read another article after that, that clears all my doubt, because the author has a different perspective from the first one, and that unique perspective helped me to understand the topic. The last question is, what if I make mistakes? So that's also a very genuine question, and I think making mistakes is okay as long as you can solve them, or as long as you can correct them. And I feel very proud to say that our coding community is very welcoming in terms of helping others. So you can always reach out to me or any other person in the community who you look up to, who is senior to you, and just ask for a genuine feedback. I am sure he will be happy to help you out. That way you can even learn quickly and resolve the mistakes you don't know that don't know exist, and he will make you get your article more presentable. On a side note, I will say that we have a program called the Next Big Writer. It's a mentorship program that helps the newcomer beginner writer in gaining confidence in their learning. If you write an article, you might think that, oh, this might not be good enough, or these are not up to the community standard. So what we are doing is we are encouraging people to write and providing constructive feedback to get you better, so that you gain confidence in your writing and you can share with the community without any fear. So feel free to reach out at thenextbigwriter.tech or reach me out on Twitter if you want to join this mentorship program. And of course, this is completely free. Let's move on to the next section. Why you should start a blog. You might say that, yeah, Shad, I know I can blog, and I should blog, but what are the benefits? Is it really worth it to dedicate time for blogging? So we are just going to talk about the benefits here. So the first thing I will say here is your communication skills get a lot better by writing. And this not only helps you in your writing process, but also helps you in your career as a developer. Because whenever you are at your work, you are documenting some process, or you are collaborating with a team. So having good communication skill is a must. And even if you are collaborating with a team, you can share your concerns or share your concern to the senior in a better way. So in this way, blogging is definitely going to help you. Second thing is having a deeper understanding of the topic. Because whenever you are writing, suppose you wrote about a topic called All About Promises in JavaScript. So what you will do is you will spend a good amount of time in exploring that topic. You will learn what are the different ways to create a promise, what are the pros and cons of promises, where to use promises and where to not, and every little thing about it. Then you will write that topic. So what this will do is this will provide you with a much greater confidence that you will get if you are just going to code at work. So coding is one level of learning, and sharing your learning is the second level, and that is much deeper level than the first one. So yeah, having a deeper understanding gives you a huge boost in confidence at work too. Third benefit I can say is you get a lot of exposure. Whenever you are sharing your article with the community, there will be people who will be reading you, and they might think that, yeah, this person really knows his stuff. And that will give you a little bit of popularity, I can say, and an exposure as well. One more thing I can list is you can get job opportunities and freelancing gigs as well. This happened to me all the time, that the recruiter or concerned person happened to be on one of my articles, and he reached out to me via a mail that we have this project and would you like to collaborate on this. So if you are looking for a new job or freelancing gigs, this will provide you a huge plus. And not to forget that having an active blog on resume makes you stand out of the rest of the applicants. So it is going to look really good on your resume and will give you a plus point. One last thing I can say is it also opens ways to public speaking. So when you are writing, you already have the content. So now you will have to do is just find a way to present it to the community. And the first two talks of my career was also converted from the article. I wrote a blog first and then converted it back to a talk and gave it. So this opens your way to public speaking. So let's recall what we just learned. It improves communication skills. It gives you a deeper understanding of the topic. It gives you exposure in the community, helps you in getting job and freelancing gigs. Yes, this I forgot. It provides you earning opportunities as well. There are a lot of publishers that pay you to write it, and you can get paid up to $300 per article. What you will have to do is write for some time, gain some experience, and submit your three best articles to the publisher, and they will decide if you can write for them or not. I know a few people that are writing full time in their career and earning more than what they could on their day job. So there is a huge earning opportunity as well. And the last one was opens your way to public speaking. So now you know that you can blog. Now you know that you should blog. Let's tackle this question on how to start a blog. So whenever you are starting a blog, there is a lot of questions in our mind that what are the platforms to choose and what are the tools to use, how to write and et cetera, so let's drop down to these two points. The first one is which platform to choose and what tools to use. So there are multiple platforms in our community. One is Hashnode, of course, and second is Dev2 and Medium. So whenever you are choosing a platform, you should consider about two things. One is SEO and second is content ownership. If you write an article, you want to own the content. Okay, and the main problem with platforms like Medium is you don't own the content. They are the actual owner, because whenever you write an article, the URL will be medium.com/allaboutpromises. And if you own your content and you publish on your own personal domain, then the URL will be, suppose in my case, imshadmirza.com/allaboutpromises. And you are free to change the URL or update it or migrate your blog to another platform or do anything with it. You own the complete, you have the complete ownership. And for this reason, I will suggest you to use Hashnode. Hashnode lets you blog on your domain, customize your SEO for the best ranking, gives you all kind of stuff that you will need to write, so that you can focus on writing instead of maintaining your blog. And by owning your content, you will have to do a small investment. You will have to buy your domain and link it to your website. So yeah. And if you are going to buy a domain and create your own blog, there are few approaches that you can follow. One is Hashnode. Second is you can go with a static blog like Gatsby or Ghost. They are also really, really good options. But you will have to maintain the blog yourself. You will have to maintain the meta tags and cover images and everything, and take care of the hosting, where your content is saving. Every tiny things you will have to take care of yourself. But with Hashnode, we are customizing everything for you, so you can focus give your 100% focus to the writing, only the writing. You just go to Hashnode, open the editor, write your blog and publish it, and it directly goes to the Hashnode feed. And one other plus point you get is you get a huge audience boost. If you are blogging on Gatsby and Ghost, you don't have any audience, and you will have to get help from Twitter or Reddit when you are sharing, and then those people will read you. But with Hashnode, there is a huge community of very supportive people that will be ready to read your article. So yeah, a huge audience boost even in your first article. And also you can cross post and get benefit from all the communities. You can publish on your own domain and cross post to Dev2 or Medium and get the benefit of all the communities. Second thing is what tools to use. So one is writing what you will use to write the article. You can use Notion or any Markdown. Just create a Markdown file in a folder and use VS Code to write your article in Markdown, or you can go to Hashnode and we have an amazing editor. You can use that editor to write your blog. Second thing is you will have to check for spelling mistakes and punctuation errors. So you can use Grammarly for that. Just copy paste complete article onto the Grammarly and correct those mistakes and then publish it. So what we learned so far, we learned that you can blog. Second is you should blog. Third is how to start a blog. Now let's move on to the next section. What topics to write on or how to choose a topic. So while there are certain scenarios that you can follow or certain approaches that you can take to decide the topic, but you have to take the one idea in mind. You have to get the instance the main idea behind choosing a topic is you have to learn the process love the process. If you love the process will be much easier and you will be able to complete the blog. So let's talk about few of the approaches, like love the process, but how. Okay, so one thing is you can choose something that you want to learn. Suppose you have in mind that Next.js seems very interesting and I want to learn it. So what you can do is take a course and learn Next.js, and while make some notes about your learning, what are your findings, and write a blog. Say you can give it a title like 5 things I learned while exploring Next.js. That's an awesome article to go. So one way is that learn something and then share your learnings. Second is share that you recently learned. Suppose you learned something new, something, some gotcha or something at work, so you can document that and write an article. Third point is choose something that you are genuinely interested in. If you are interested in something, then you will definitely love it, and it will be a much pleasant experience for you to write. Fourth is, if you had a tough time solving something at work, then write about it. If you stuck on a problem at work, then again, some other person might stuck on it as well. So what you can do is you can write about that topic, and the other person, if that comes after you, will find that article and definitely thank you for helping him out. Fifth and the last point is follow communities like Free Code Camp and Hacker Noon. So let me tell you one thing, that some articles perform better than others. How? Suppose I wrote an article called How to Add Notifications in a React Native App. So my audience is limited to the people who are coding in React Native. And even in that, the person who is looking to add notification will read my article. So my audience is very small. But if I write an article called 5 tips to write you better HTML, then my audience base is very large, because a lot of people are coding in HTML than React Native. So in my second example, my article will reach much more people than the previous example. So you can follow communities like Free Code Camp and Hacker Noon and see what they are posting. What are the articles that are performing well? And come up with some topics on your own. And those topics will have a good chance to go viral. Okay, now how to structure your blog? This is the main, this is the gist of this talk, and I want you to focus here. First, the main problem with writing is that it takes a lot of motivation to write, because writing a 1500 to 2000 word article is not a easy task, and it often feels daunting even to start. And even I myself have felt a lack of motivation sometimes, and just skip the writing process altogether. So what you can do in this situation is you can make the whole writing process as easy as possible. And how we can do that? We can divide the whole process into mini tasks and focus on one at a time so that it feels easier. So you are not now focusing on writing a 1500 articles. You are focusing on writing a 5-line paragraph. That's it. So let's talk about the process. And by the way, by this process, you can write even without motivation. First, you will have to write a description. In description, greet the user. Hello, good morning, anything. And then talk about what this article is going to be about. What are the ideas you will share, and what is the gist of this article? You will have to make it concise and provide value to the reader so that reader decides to read further. Then what you can do is write 4 or 5 bullet points, and that bullet point will contain the ideas that you want to share. If it's a theory or explanation article, then it will contain the ideas or certain sections. And if it's a tutorial, it can contain the steps, like step 1, step 2, like that. So write 4 or 5 bullet points. And then what you will have to do is expand those points. Take those points, make them heading, and write 2-3 paragraphs in each of them and explain what you mean by those points and how you can do that. Okay, explain the topics, explain the points. And then the last step will be, after you are done writing, expanding those points, just add a takeaway at the end. But in takeaway, tell the user what you just explained, what he just learned, and what he can take away from this, from your talk. Reader are much more interested in the takeaway part, and it will help the reader to remember your article for a longer time. So don't forget the takeaways. Let's quickly recall what we just learned. You have to write a description, greet the reader, write a 2-3 line description is enough, and provide value, why you want the reader to read further. Get the attention, and then write bullet points, write the ideas that you want to share in short points, and then make them as headings, and expand around those headings, and write some paragraphs inside those. Then at the end, add a takeaway and explain what you tell the reader what you just explained. So it's like a sandwich kind of thing. On the top, there is the metadata that you just that you want to explain. Second, the middle layer is the actual explanation. And the third is takeaway, telling the reader what you just explained. Okay, so this process, I learned this process from the amazing teacher, Stephen Grider, and it has been working for me with much ease and great. Yeah, so the structure part we have done. Now let's move on to the next section, blogging best practices. Okay, so when you are writing, you will have to keep these in mind. One is starting the stuff, make it easy. We just discussed, and the process we discussed, write a description, then bullet point, then takeaway. This is going to provide your mind a mental map, a mental roadmap, and also to the reader a mental roadmap that we are going to learn these things, and it will make the process a lot easier. Remember, pushing a halted car is much more difficult than pushing a moving car. So this little process will provide you enough push to get going. Second point is have an idea log. Don't discard any ideas. Collect them, and even if you feel like it's not good enough, don't discard them. Just keep it in the idea log. Even you can experiment them later. Okay, the third point is tell what you just want to explain, tell what you want to explain, then explain that thing. And then at the last, tell what you just explained, the sandwich approach. Or I can say the burger approach. The fourth point is use short, concise sentences. Don't use long sentences. Don't use difficult words. Make it as easy as possible. Don't try to sound smart, try to sound helpful. This will, if you can nail this part, you can provide value, you can sound helpful, then you are good to go. The fifth point is divide blog into a small paragraph, section and points. If you have a long sentence, divide them into two and make them two sentences. If you have long paragraph, divide them into two and make them small paragraphs. Because what happens is when the reader is reading your article, he never reads the word, he never read word by word. So he is just going to skim through the content and see if it contains what he wants. So if you divide the blog into a smaller paragraph, small sentences, this is going to be easier for the reader to skim through your content or scan through your content. So yeah, and you can also use some bold keyword to highlight the things that you want to highlight. Like in this particular side, I have made the points that I want to highlight into in a different color. So this, I hope this sticks to you at the end of the talk. Yeah, and also these, don't forget to add takeaway. Takeaways are very important. You want your article to stick to the reader's mind. You want them to remember the learnings for a longer duration of time. So add a takeaway. The title needs the spotlight. Yeah, spend good amount of time writing the title because this is what the reader is going to read and then decide if he wants to click on your blog or not. So make it as interesting as possible. Then the eighth point is add relatable example. Choose something that the user might be familiar with. Choose some characters from the famous show like Joey from the Friends or something like that. Choose your name or cats or dogs, something that just make it relatable. Next is remove unnecessary words. Let me give you an example. Suppose there is a sentence called, in my personal opinion. So when you say in my personal opinion, the word personal is not adding any more meaning to it. In my personal opinion and in my opinion, both have the exact same meaning. So you can opt out the word personal from it. So look out for such words, that, so, something like that. So, and make the sentences shorter and concise. Then you can use there is an extension called Keywords Everywhere. You can use it to find certain keywords that the user have been searching on the internet and include those keywords in the title of the blog or in the article. This will give you a huge boost in terms of SEO. The end with call to action. Make the article much more engaging. Add your Twitter link and ask the reader to follow you on Twitter or ask for feedback in the comments or just ask them what they want you to write next. Make it engaging. Yeah, and don't forget to add takeaways. Today we learned, should you start writing? The answer is yes. I hope I am able to convince you. What are the benefits of having a blog? How to start a blog? How to choose topics? And how to structure your blog? That description, bullet point, takeaway approach. And what are the blogging best practices? I hope this talk was helpful to you. And again, thank you so much for having me. And yeah, feel free to follow me on Twitter if you like this talk or reach out to me or visit thenextspeakwriter.tech. If you need any help in blogging or in gaining confidence, we will make sure to provide constructive feedback and make you better as quickly as possible. Thank you.
Thank you everyone for being an amazing audience. We at DSC Kite extend our sincere thanks to Shad Mirza for providing such an informative insight into technical writing. And do remain connected with us for more such enlightening talks. The link to our social handles are mentioned in the description box. Thanks all.